Hello everyone, so welcome back to a physics class. Now since we had completed both the chapters, that is chapter 2, that was your measurement chapter, and we had just now completed chapter number 3, that is force and pressure, and these two chapters are part of your second unit test paper. So today I want to start with the revision of chapter number 2, because we had completed a month before this chapter, so I want to revise this chapter so that you people can understand the things, revise the things properly, and you will able to do well in your paper, in your exam. So first thing, the chapter consists of measurement, and measurement of density is generally talked about here in this chapter. So let us begin with the topic density. So first of all, we should know what is density. The amount of matter present in unit volume, so there is some fixed volume, and how much amount of matter means how much amount of mass is present in that fixed volume, that is known as density. And the formula to calculate density is mass upon volume. So if you know the mass of a substance, and if you know the correct volume of that substance, then you can divide both the things and the answer will be your density. And the standard unit to calculate density is kg per meter cube, because the mass, it is measured in kilogram, that is the standard unit, and volume, it is measured in meter cube. So this will be your standard unit, that is SI unit, for calculating the density of a substance. Whereas if you want to calculate smaller values, okay, which is having smaller units, then the CGS unit to calculate the density is gram per centimeter cube. So if smaller units are given, then it will become gram per centimeter cube. If bigger values are given, then it will become kg per meter cube. And you should remember the relationship also, that 1 gram per centimeter cube is equals to 1000 kg per meter cube. So please remember this equation, this comparison, which is very, very important, because sometimes they will give you the values in gram per centimeter cube and they will ask you the solution or the result in kilogram per meter cube, that is in the standard unit. So you should know it has to be multiplied by 1000. Now, measurement of density of irregular solids. So suppose if you want to calculate the density of regular solids, regular means whose shape, size is very fixed. In that condition, you can measure the mass and you can calculate the volume by using the formula of volume of solid substances. But the condition comes, how to measure the volume, density of irregular solids. So irregular solids means solids whose volume is not fixed. So density of irregular shaped solids can be measured by using measuring cylinder or Eureka can. So if you remember, I have already told you, measuring cylinder is a cylinder which consists of measurement from 0 mL to 100 mL or 1000 mL, it depends upon its quantity. And by using this measuring cylinder, you can measure the volume. How you can measure the volume? Suppose you take the liquid up to a specific volume. Suppose I will take a liquid whose volume is 50 mL, okay, and then in that liquid I will pour that solid substance whose volume I want to measure. And when you pour that solid substance, some volume of water will going to increase, or some volume of that liquid will going to rise. So this change in volume is because of that solid substance, and that will give you the formula by final volume minus initial volume, means whatever was the volume at the earlier case before placing that solid, and what is the volume after placing that solid, you have to take out the difference of both the things. Whatever the difference is there, that will be your change of volume, and that will be the volume of irregular shaped solid. Now, mass of that solid you can easily measure by using a beam balance or a physical balance. So then you can apply the formula, the same formula, that is mass upon volume, and you will get the actual density of that particular substance. So this is how you can measure by using a cylinder. Which kind of cylinder? That is measuring cylinder. Similarly, Eureka can is also used in the same manner, and that is how you can measure the volume of solid, and you can use the formula of density, that is mass upon volume, and you can calculate the density. Now, to measure the volume of irregular shape solid. One numerical is there, let us discuss a numerical, which is the part of your syllabus and given in your book also. A measuring cylinder is filled with 50 ml of water. Okay, suppose a measuring cylinder is there and which is already filled with how much amount of water? 50 ml of water. So in the solution part, you will note down given initial volume of water. Okay, so before pouring the solid, whatever is the volume of water is there, that is initial volume of water, and that is 50 ml, and that I will denote it by VI, initial volume, or V1, let us write V1, first volume. Okay, then a solid with mass 16 grams, so mass of solid, which is M, is equals to 16 gram, is lower into the cylinder. So this mass of solid, I don't know whether the shape was regular or irregular, but they're just saying that the mass of solid whose mass of 16 gram has been poured inside water inside the cylinder, the water level rises to 58 ml. So final volume, okay, V2, I will consider it V2, that is final volume of water, that is equals to 58 ml. Now you can see that there is some difference in the volume of liquid. Earlier it was 50 ml, now the volume has become 58 ml. This change in volume is because of volume of solid. So let us calculate what was the second volume, 58 ml minus first volume, 50 ml, that will give you 8 ml, or you can write it as 8 centimeter cube also, 8 centimeter cube, because solids we generally measure in centimeter cube or meter cube. So milliliter can be converted into centimeter cube. 1 milliliter is equals to 1 centimeter cube. Earlier in the class I have already discussed each and everything in detail, so you can look for those classes also and you can understand in detail. So 8 centimeter cube or 8 ml is the volume of the solid, and what is the mass of the solid? 16 gram. So density of solid, it will become mass upon volume. What is the mass? 16 gram upon 8 centimeter cube, which will become 2 gram per centimeter cube. So this will be the density of this particular solid. Now, after talking about the density of solid, let us talk about the density of liquid. So it is very easy to measure the density of liquid. How you can measure? Density of liquid can be measured by first measuring its mass. So first of all, you should know the mass of the liquid. Now, how you can take the mass of the liquid? So for that, take a beaker, basically an empty beaker, okay, and then measure the mass of the empty beaker, okay, because it is difficult to directly measure the mass of a liquid because liquid can flow. So first of all, you take the beaker, empty beaker, and then measure the mass of that empty beaker. Suppose the mass of empty beaker is 100 gram. Now pour liquid inside that beaker whose density you want to know. So suppose you take water of up to 100 ml, that is the volume of the water is 100 ml, and pour it inside that beaker and then measure the mass again. Now this time you are measuring the mass of beaker including water. So water is also there and beaker is also there. So this time the mass will obviously will be more than in the first case. Whatever the mass, suppose the mass is coming as 200 gram. So earlier the mass was 100 gram, now the mass is 200 gram. So this difference is because of the mass of liquid. So this is how you can get the mass of the liquid. Second mass minus first mass. That means 200 gram minus 100 gram. From previous mass, from the new mass, you subtract the previous mass. So you will get the mass of the liquid. Now after getting the mass of the liquid, what you do? You measure its volume. And how you will measure its volume? By using a measuring cylinder. So keep pour it in the measuring cylinder, whatever the volume is being shown over there, that will be the volume of the liquid, and you can apply the formula of density, that is mass upon volume. So this is how you can easily measure the density of liquid. Now another important term is relative density. Relative density means the comparison of density. So let us talk about the comparison, that is the relative density. The relative density of a substance is defined as the ratio of the density of the substance to the density of water. When we compare the density of any substance with respect to water, okay, and water should be at 4 degrees Celsius, so we are taking the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius, which is generally 1 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, so if you compare the density of any substance, solid, liquid, anything, with density of water at 4 degrees Celsius, then this comparison is actually known as relative density, which I denoted by RD, relative density, and the formula becomes density of a substance divided by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. So this is a very basic formula to calculate the density of, sorry, the relative density of any substance. If the relative density of a substance, if relative density of substance is coming more than 1, greater than 1, in that condition that object will going to sink inside water. And if the relative density is less than or equal to 1, in those conditions, in both the conditions, that object will partially or completely float over water. Now let us talk about the unit for relative density. So since it is a ratio, as I told you, it is a ratio, so relative density will not have any kind of unit. So there will be no unit for relative density, as it is a ratio of density of a substance with respect to density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. So one very simple numerical is there, which is based on your density and relative density topic. So let us discuss the simple numerical. Okay, so the question says that a piece of coal, so there is a piece of coal, has a mass of 40 grams. So mass is given is equals to 40 grams, and the volume of that particular coal is 30 centimeter cube. So volume is 30 centimeter cube. So mass is also given, volume is also given. So we can easily calculate the density of coal. Density of coal, which is equals to mass upon volume. Mass is 40 gram upon 30 centimeter cube. 0, 0 got cancelled. 4 upon 3 gram per centimeter cube, or 1.33 grams per centimeter cube in decibels. So this is how you can calculate the density of coal. Now, since we know the density of coal, now you have to calculate the relative density also. So relative density means density of substance, that is coal, upon density of water. Now please remember, density of water is basically 1 gram per centimeter cube when we are talking about in grams, and it will become 1000 kg per meter cube in case of kilogram per meter cube. So over here we require only grams per centimeter cube. So density of coal is 1.33 grams per centimeter cube upon density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Both the units will get cancelled. When you divide it by 1, answer will be 1.33. So this is the relative density of this coal, which is equals to 1.33. Since relative density is more than 1, so this object will going to sink inside liquid. So if they ask whether the object will going to sink or whether the object will going to float, so you can answer that object will going to sink inside water because the relative density is more than 1. So let us talk about flotation and sinking. If the density of solid is less than the density of liquid, suppose one solid is there and you want to know whether this solid will going to float over that liquid or it will going to sink inside the liquid, for that condition you should know the density of solid and you should know the density of liquid. If the density of solid is less than the density of liquid in that condition, that solid object will going to float on the liquid. But if the density of liquid, sorry, solid is more than the density of liquid, so what will happen? The object will going to sink in the liquid. So this is how you can know whether which object will going to float or which object will going to sink. And this is how we people come to know whether the ship will going to float inside water or whether the ship will going to sink, under the consideration of knowing the fact that whose density is more. So these are the topics which you have to revise firstly, and please start revising your second, third chapter also, that is force and pressure, which I have already completed just now. So both the chapters you have to balance it for your upcoming unit test paper. Okay, thank you.